Hey guys, day 25 of the 100 day challenge. I'm a quarter of the way there, but I don't think I'll stop at this because I'm having so much fun doing the videos and I hope you guys are too. If you want to keep following the videos that I'm putting out there, I'm going to be doing a lot of showing a lot of tools and a lot of extra bits and pieces that are coming through for me. Click the subscribe button below and you'll get an email with all the new stuff that I'm putting out. So today what we're going to be talking about is a new awareness that I've been playing around with. As you probably well know, I experiment a lot with my own life to be able to share as much as possible with everyone else out there. And what I've been playing around with is the concept of love and how people can feel or can be in love or can be in love with someone or can love someone but still have something missing. So if you're one of those people who can resonate with the fact of being in love with someone or loving someone but knowing that there's something missing, I think I've put my finger on it. Only by just experimenting with different processes and different ways, I've been able to connect with what love does for us and what love is for us as humans in a body on a planet. And then if we have love, what is then missing if love is evident? So I felt a little bit more into what love means, and love in fact is an emotion. So you feel love, an emotion that can either be feeling in love or loving someone, and it's more of a soul-based involuntary feeling, and it's also a way of being. So you can be love, like you can radiate love. And so it's more of a soul-based process. And this is why when we are in a human body, this is why love is not enough, because you can love someone but have something missing. And this is what I've been playing around with, is what is love and what is this thing that's missing if love is evident? So feel into love. I've got lots of love hearts around me, which there's lots of love around me, right? There's lots and lots of love. You can have lots of love around you. You can have lots of family. You can have lots of friends who love you. But when there's something missing, it's hard to put your finger on what that thing is. So I've been playing around with the concept of love and what that missing element was. And just the other day, I was writing down, you know, what I want from a relationship, what I want in my life. And writing those things down, it actually came through as a download as to what can be missing when you seem to have it all, but you don't feel like you have. So the thing that can be missing if you are in love or you love someone or you have lots of love around you, what can be missing is the element of caring. So as soon as I connected to caring, I thought, okay, and I received the word caring. Okay, so I looked into, okay, what is the difference between caring and love? And the thing that came through around that is caring isn't actually love. It's an action that's human-based behavior. So caring is an action which is sometimes representative of love, but it's not love. Caring is a completely different concept altogether from love. So caring is a voluntary thing. It's something that you choose to do. Sometimes when you're in love or you love someone, you don't have a choice. It's involuntary. So then I felt into, okay, so what's the difference between self-love and self-care? So people will say, oh, I have got lots of self-love because I give myself a bath every week. I go for a walk. I take time out. That is actually not self-love. That is self care. So you can see their actions, their human actions that you're doing for yourself, that is care for self or self-care. It's not actually self-love. Self-love is acceptance of yourself the way you are. See, it's not an action. It's a feeling. It's going on inside. It's soul-based. So it's accepting self regardless, like unconditional love. It's different. It's actually accepting yourself as truth and owning your truth as to who you are. That is self-love. Can you see the difference? Self-care is the doing. Self-love is the feeling or the acceptance of who you are. And that's the same with external love. You can have external love where someone loves you, but if you have no caring from that person, which can be something that can happen at the same time. You can actually have someone who loves you, but they don't care for you. So it may be, if I can resort back to, it can be a parent that loves, or your parents that loved you, but they didn't care for you. Can you see the difference? And caring, a lot of it is perception. So it's how we perceive that caring, or if someone cares about us. If caring is missing, you can see in even in that relationship, if a parent loves a child but a child doesn't feel cared for, then the love pretty much means nothing. And so that completely then doesn't even make the love real. It's just null and void pretty much. So you can also have family. You can love your family, but you don't care for them. Vice versa. You can then go into, well, I have friends that I care for, but, you know, I mean, I love everyone, but you might have friends that care for you, but they aren't necessarily in love with you. or, you know, you can care for clients and things like that. Yes, you can love them as well, but it's different. So what I'm trying to say is that what if we could bring love and care together? Imagine how powerful that would be. There, that would actually completely not only change the world, but change your life, but also the world as well. So the thing I connected to is that if we cared for the planet, then we would look after it. Obviously, we love the planet, but we're not caring for it. See the difference? If we cared for each other, or if we loved each other but cared for each other, then we would look out for each other. And if we then loved and cared for ourselves, then we would have that combination of respect, acceptance, truth, and the baths and the walks and all that sort of thing. We need both love and caring to be evident in our lives to be fulfilled. So I went into the difference so you can really get a handle on what the difference is between love and caring. And then what you can do is you can start to not only bring it into your life by caring for yourself in this way, but also bringing it into your relationships and also how you deal with the world as a whole. If we could start caring more, as well as loving the stuff that's around us, then we will see a lot of shift, because caring is an action which has a reaction. I mean, it's a universal law that when you have, there is an action, there's a reaction. So if we care, then things will change. So I'm going to feel into the difference between love and caring, so then you can see that we need both, because they are both very different. So if I can look at love again, love is an emotion. It's soul-based. It's actually a way of being. So the words that come up around love is passion, lust, admiration, adoring, giving your heart to, desiring, longing. There's romance. So that's kind of all the concept around love. It is a soul-based concept. And of course, that needs to come from within, because it's a soul-based concept. Caring is a human-based concept. So being caring means you're interested, like you're listening. It means nurturing someone else or yourself. It means supporting. It means protecting. It means providing for, respecting, being considerate of others, paying attention to someone or to yourself, looking after, acknowledging, again, listening, honoring, being concerned, and, you know, just that level of devotion. So it's actually caring is the act of love, but you need both to feel the whole concept of love. And also, you know, the phrase, are you okay? Like asking yourself this. I've made a habit of myself having a daily meeting with myself and asking myself, am I okay? I'm going to be caring for myself from a place of, are you emotionally okay? Are you physically okay? That's how I'm going to care for myself, is by acknowledging that. But I can love myself by simply being, because it's acceptance of who I am. Can you see the difference? So then looking into, you know, love and care together, it is a very powerful universal recipe of universal peace. Like it's a really powerful connection of both. Because we are souls in a body, this is where if we have one without the other, there's a disconnect there. We need to bring our soul-based level of love into our human-based level of caring and then bring them together. So starting with ourselves, love and caring for ourselves, which again is truth, honesty, acceptance, combined with the physical caring for ourselves, and then loving and caring others for others. So starting with partners and family, you know, not just I love you and then ignoring, because there's ignoring, there's caring less, there's neglect. You can still love someone but neglect them. That's where problems start. And imagine if we could change that into the concept of turning neglect around to caring. That's where you've got that solid whole connection of love and caring, which will completely change whatever's going on for you in your life. Starting with self, starting with others, and then starting with everyone else around the world, like people, seeing everyone else as one, and that we are caring for everyone and loving other one as we love ourselves. And then the planet, if we cared for the planet rather than just loved it, you can really feel the difference into the love. I can love a planet, but to care for it is the act of love. So I hope that makes sense to you. It really helped me to really see my next steps in not only relationships and connections with others, but also how we see our journey here on the planet. And knowing that this has to happen for stuff to shift, not only within ourselves, but also externally as a reflection of what's going on within. You need to have self-love and self-care. You need to have love and care external to you to be completely fulfilled and happy. And then the world will have universal peace around us when we have this peace within and around us as well. Hope that's helped you. If you've got any questions, pop them below, because this is a really tricky kind of concept. It's just something that was downloaded to me. If you have a different concept around it, that's cool too. This is resonating with me right now, and if it resonates with you, I hope it can help you within your relationships and your connection with yourself and how we can change the world into being a better place. See you soon.